Now, it's one thing to be able to write a shell script or a program to get what you need done. It's another thing to write one efficiently and get things done quickly without using system resources or anything like that, and doing things elegantly. And that's what this video is going to be about. Here, I actually have two scripts here. I wrote both of these. The one on the left, I'll go ahead and say, is a newer version of the script, which is much, much better than the one on the right, which I wrote several months ago flippantly, and it has a very poor design. Now, neither of these scripts are particularly long. The new one is 34 lines, the old one is 42 lines. But I want to show you the performance difference that can make. So I'm going to run the old script here. And you'll notice that it takes a second or so. It takes a good bit of time for such a short script. That's a little surprising. I mean, it's not the end of the world just running this script, but let's compare it to the new one. And you'll see that it basically completes immediately. I mean, my finger isn't even off the enter key by the time that it's already finished. In fact, we can use, if you want to compare these, we can run time on them. And we'll see that this old one, it takes about 1.5 seconds. That's a good bit of time for a small Bash script, actually. While this one, I mean, it's nearly instantaneous. It's a couple milliseconds. It's nothing. I mean, it's a totally negligible amount of time. So I could run this script, you know, dozens, a hundred something times, I could run this smaller script, you know, a gajillion times before this script ever finished. Now, you might say, okay, well, the difference isn't that big. What's an extra second or something like that? And that's the wrong mindset to have, especially if you want to create scripts for public consumption. Because when you think about your system, it is just a bunch of scripts and programs. And how you design them, efficiency differences like this can make a huge difference. So in this video, I'm going to talk about what the difference between these two scripts are, why this one is so much slower than this one. Long story short, it all amounts to you gotta use streams and use streams effectively. But before I talk about the engineering behind them, let me just tell you what these scripts do. Now, they do the same thing, and I've actually done a video on this before. I have a little file on my computer called folders, and it is really just, it has pairs of directories with shortcuts corresponding to them. So how this works is, let me pull up Bash. What I have this script do, or either of these scripts do, is it reads a file like this, and it creates shortcuts for Bash, Ranger, and Qt Browser based on these. So for example, if I'm in Bash and I press, L and type that in, that actually goes to my LaTeX folder. Or if I press A, that goes to my articles folder, et cetera, et cetera. Or if I want to go to my art wallpapers, I just press WA and that goes there. And it shows me the contents and stuff like that. So this script just makes out aliases for that. And they also work in Ranger. So if I'm in Ranger, I can press GL to go to the LaTeX folder, or T, WC to, or what is it? TWL to go to my landscape folder or something like that and create a tab. So I just have different shortcuts and these scripts generate them. Now that you sort of understand what they're doing, I'll talk about what the engineering difference between these scripts are. Now let's look at the bad one first, okay? So I'll ignore most of this stuff up here because it's mostly the same between the two scripts. Just know that what this does, the specific way the file is outputting is that it creates separate files. So for example, the one it creates for Bash is shortcuts in my home directory, and it creates all these aliases. So that's basically the output. And what it's checking to do in these lines, it's just checking to see if this file is properly sourced by my Bash RC or something like that. But let's actually get to the actual design principles behind the script. Now, here's what it's doing computationally. Now, it has this script, and you'll see here, what it's going to do is it's going to go through each of these lines line by line. And what it's going to do, let's think about what it's actually doing for each of these lines. So this for loop is going through and going to loop through all these lines. And what it does is, first off, it sets the variable key equal to really the first column. It's echoing line and awking, you know, the first column. This is terribly, I'm looking at this, it's like terribly written. This is so inefficient, but it sets the variable key equal to this first column, and it sets the second, or it sets dir equal to the second column. That's all that does. And I'm already looking at this like so embarrassed. I can't believe I ever even wrote this, but I'll talk about why later. So it does that. It sets these variables, and let's say it's on this first line. It sets key equal to h, and it sets dir equal to you know, that sequence of tilde plus slash. Then what it does is it echoes out the proper syntax of the alias needed for bash with the key and with dir in it into the place we've specified we want our bash shortcuts. Then it echoes those same things in the proper syntax for a ranger shortcut. So here is my shortcut to go to a folder. Here's my shortcut to make a tab in the folder, to move a file to that folder, and to yank a file to that folder. And it also makes the binding for QBrowser. Now, the reason this is so, you have to think of it in terms of what it's actually outputting and where. And what this thing is in effect doing is for each of these lines that it's looping through, it's not just setting variables, which takes up time, it is outputting 6 times to different files. It's outputting to the bash RC, and then it's outputting to the ranger config 4 times, and then the QBrowser 1 time. So this is an extremely inefficient script. And in fact, actually it goes through 2 files. I mentioned I have a folder file here. I have another file for configs, and it's doing the same thing. So for each of these lines, it's looping through time and time and time and time again, and outputting files time and time and time again. And that's why it takes, you know, just to get through this document of 70 so lines, it's taking, you know, a whole second or so to do this basic operation. Now, how does that compare to the better script? What is a better way to write, do the exact same thing? So here is our good script. And in fact, I'm sure that there are many people who are going to watch this video and say, oh, there are even more ways you can improve on this, but let's go ahead and talk about what this is actually doing. Most of these lines are pretty much the same stuff, and then we get down to, again, these are still sourcing the aliases, but the key lines here, first off, we just have less lines, which, you know, can mean something. All of this corresponds to just these lines here. Now, what exactly is this doing? Now, instead of going through a loop and outputting to files time and time again, what I do here is just stream manipulation. So let's actually run part of this script manually. So I'm going to go up to this, I'm going to copy that, I'm going to set folders equal to that so we can run this command. And I am, actually, let's put it up here so you can see it a little better. So I'm going to take this line, and I'm going to copy it out. It doesn't matter if I... So I'm just going to run, for example, the first part of this command. Now first we're going to run sed on the folders. Now sed is just a stream editor. Maybe I should run cat first. So if we are just going to cat out this file to show the contents, we see that, okay, well, we have all these contents here. Now if we run sed, this sed command, just as an abbreviation, this isn't so important, but sometimes I put comments in my folder files. This thing basically says, whenever you see a line that starts with a pound sign, just delete it. Just don't show it. That's all this sed command does. But ultimately, this is just going to output the file without those comments. That's all it's going to say. Now, what we do here, instead of iterating through each of these lines, with a for loop or something like that, what I actually do is just use awk to format this in a different way. With awk, we can take the elements of this file and just reformat them in a different, just a different way. And how we do that is with the print command. So if I print this out, I'm really just telling the file, print out the following sequence. Print out alias, and then the first column, and then seed change directory, and then the second column, and then all the rest of the stuff that we need in a bash shortcut. Now, unlike our first, actually, I'm going to type this out for a second. You can mull that over as I type this out, because I can't even say anything while I'm typing all this stuff out. I have to actually think about it. Oh, wait, I'm stupid. I just copied it a second ago. Why don't I just do that? See? Now, if I run this command, what it's actually doing is instead of looping through all of that stuff and outputting, it's really just modifying the stream that we have. It's just taking this, sending it as a stream to awk, and modifying the whole thing. So instead of looping through all of this stuff and outputting one by one, we've now just modified the entire stream. So this one command, which happens basically instantaneously, it's really just give me the contents of this file and perform this operation on the entire file. It gives me all of that stuff that we had that for loop for instantaneously. And then I just output it to the shell shortcuts folder. Now notice this, I do the same thing. I do it three times for each of the three configs I have for Bash, Ranger, and Qt Browser. Notice for the Qt Browser, well, we'll do the Ranger one. That's the important one. For the Ranger one, going to get rid of this so it outputs to the shell. I'll actually move it over here. For the Ranger one, I even have multiple lines. So I actually have new lines here. So what I effectively have is I have the shortcut file, and I can still edit the stream such that I'm for each one of the lines in this, I'm actually going to have four different lines in the Ranger config because I have four different shortcuts for going to the folder, a new tab in the folder, doing different operations to that folder. But if I just run this, you'll see that it's very easy to modify the stream to have multiple lines. And again, while previously we were outputting the file for each one of these lines, it is just one much more elegant line here. Well, it's ugly looking, but it's very elegant because we really just say reformat for each of these lines, reformat them as four different lines and print that whole file out. And that's what it's doing. So this is the reason it's so much more effective, because when you're thinking about files as being sort of, or when you're thinking about operations on the command line as being sort of streams, I could cat out a file, or I could effectively cat it out with sed, you know, with this command, which also deletes the comments. I could treat that as a stream and then just give it to awk, and awk is sort of filtering through it, performing this operation on it, and it's just going directly to the place that, you know, we want it to end up at. So this is a much more efficient way of writing than the for loop that goes through the whole thing and, you know, outputs the file a gajillion times. And so that's more or less why it's a more efficient way of I guess, doing things. So anyway, I hope this has been, I guess, instructive. If you want to know anything more specific about the script, it's on my GitHub. I guess I'll put a link to that. Or you can ask any questions. If you have suggestions to make this thing even faster or more efficient or something like that, you can just say so. Notice, you know, we have a good time here, but it always helps to have, you know, more efficient code. And there's probably something that I've totally overlooked here that someone's going to point out. But anyway, this has sort of been a perfect public service announcement, because I think it is important to, you know, I think writing scripts and writing programs, even though I've only been, you know, writing scripts for my YouTube channel for the past couple years, it's been a journey in, you have to get in a mindset of how to do things efficiently. And once you get in that mindset, there are huge benefits to it. And you're also doing, honestly, sometimes when people write, people come to writing programs or scripts with this mentality of, oh, let me just import all these, you know, modules in Python and do all this complicated stuff that really a basic shell command, a basic core utility that every Unix-based operating system has can just do it instantaneously. So anyway, it's just a public service announcement. If you write something, always make sure to make it more efficient. So that's about it. So see you guys next time.